Thank you very much. The co-founder and chairwoman, Global Peace Women Foundation, Dr. Mrs. Moon, my co-speakers, our esteemed delegates from all over the world, our ladies and gentlemen, our few men that are here to support us, we thank you for coming. I'm highly delighted to be part of yet another peace convention and to have the honor of being amongst the speakers at this auspicious Global Peace Convention, a global organization that is synonymous to peace, of which I am very proud to be part of it. It was just like yesterday that I attended the GPC in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia in 2013. It is still a fresh memory in my mind due to the experiences and lessons derived from that convention, which has been an inspiration to me. It was the turning point in our collective efforts to ensure peace always reigns in Nigeria. The takeaway from that convention and subsequent interactions and programs by the Global Peace Foundation Nigeria has not only changed and facilitated more peace building processes, but has also widened the horizon and provided more platforms for sensitization, education, and dialogue amongst warring factions, especially in Kaduna and other parts of northern Nigeria. We view peace as synonymous to development. Hence, we take every step possible to ensure its sustainability. Kaduna State of recent has witnessed a lot of communal clashes, and that has led to the loss of lives and properties, which we are doing our best to see that harmony and peace reigns in those communities. My ICARE NGO, Women and Youth Initiative, whose primary aim is to improve the life of women, youth, the physically challenged, and other vulnerable persons in the society, started paying more attention to peace facilitation and peace building processes ever than before. We believe that the active participation of women leads to development of peaceful and just society. For overall development of women in any country, focus must be given on factors like education, gender-friendly laws, strong political commitment for women development, mainstreaming of women issues, empowerment, which is very important, and increment of women participation and creation of effective environment for development. We use our privileged positions to advocate women participation, especially in leadership, peace building, and also to engage our traditional and religious leaders on the level and platforms of peace. Our efforts are gradually yielding results, as women to some extent now play roles in peace building and are carried along in many aspects that were hitherto exclusive and reserved for men folk in our country. Women's relevance to the overall development of the society, as well as influence, especially over youth, is increasingly emerging and used to achieve peace and harmony. A point in reference is the rising profile of women's situations rooms made up of prominent African women that have now become forced to reckon with in politics, especially in the build-up during and after our elections in almost all African countries. The women's situation rooms engage mostly the youths and mobilize them to be in the vanguard to ensure peaceful elections. The role they played in facilitating peaceful elections in Kenya, Uganda, Nigeria, and Ghana are pointers to the effectiveness of new models of peace-building processes which are both preventive and curative. Vijaya Pandit says, and I quote, "The more we sweat in peace, the less we bleed in war." I hope you all agree with me. And I also usually add, it is better to win peace than to win wars. Being natural peace lovers and peacemakers, women are more sensitive to the well-being of others. We therefore continuously explore their compassion, love, care, and cooperative and temperament that make peace building and conflict resolution achievable and sustainable. These are not only assertions or sentiments. They have proved to be so in our country, which has been suffering violent clashes and insurgency. Women, children, and other vulnerable people are mostly affected. We have always strived to ensure that these are reduced to the barest minimum by exploring the peace mechanisms available to us and using dialogue as a key. That is why I find the theme of the 2017 Global Peace Convention, and I quote, "Moral and innovative leadership, new models for peace and development," spot on. The natures of conflicts keep getting sophisticated. Moral and innovative leadership are imperative to addressing them. And these are models that will facilitate peace and development fast and efficient. These, however, need local, national, and international partnerships. The Global Peace Foundation Nigeria is already doing much by engaging stakeholders to facilitate peace under one family, under God. We have also delved into social problems that threaten the society, such as substance abuse by women, which we took a strong measure and adopted a comprehensive approach to address this issue. We have equally partnered with other like-minds, groups, and individuals to ensure that peace, harmony, and tranquility reigns. In the course of our efforts to build women confidence to contribute to peace building in their communities, I always urge them to be peaceful, to preach peace, to act peacefully, and live peacefully. We always emphasize on these five attributes as our guiding principles. Number one, we do encourage our women to be proud of our gender and never consider it a weakness or disadvantage, but as a tool for peace and character building. In most cases, especially in our countries, women do not value their worth, or they don't even believe or recognize that they are very valuable and they can contribute to the development of the society. What we try to do is to build their esteem so that they could take up their challenges and responsibilities as mothers. In the family, the women are supposed to complement their husbands, especially in a society like in the African setting. We believe that the family unit is the bedrock of any society. It is the primary institution of morals, values, and character building. A woman, I believe, is the first teacher any human being can ever get. For her to be a good teacher, I believe she should be educated. In a society like ours, where early marriages is common, we strongly advocate for women, for girls to be educated. I am an advocate of girl child education because we believe educating the girl child is empowering her. And she being the first teacher in the family, she is expected to be imparting positive knowledge. And if she is an illiterate, we keep wondering what she is going to impact on the child, and then what will be the outcome in our societies. Like the adage usually goes, charity begins at home. We believe if the woman is well educated and she imparts positive moral attitudes and values on the children, they will not only be good citizens in the home, but also in the society. And hopefully, they will be our future leaders. Number two, we also try to emphasize that women should be in peace within our inner selves. In most cases, women, if they are in a bad situation or very temperament, you will see that the children will be in a discomfortable situation and it will not produce a character that will be helpful to the society. So being happy and making others happy and instilling compassion and love in our children will definitely produce a healthy community. It will pave way for love and compassion and harmony in our schools and the community at large. We also emphasize a healthy, honest, mutual respect and compassion relationship in the home as well as in the community. We appreciate our potentials and we try to deploy it appropriately to produce positive results. We stress on the respect of other people's values, their culture, their religion, their beliefs, irrespective of our diversity. We believe that is where love and compassion should start. And this will definitely lead to respect of others' people's lives. These are the magic wand we wave to turn hostility into hospitality. We turn hate into love and punches into embrace. But most importantly, our ceaseless and fervent prayers are paramount to sustainable peace and development. I would like to end this with this quote by Robert Fulham, which has almost become a permanent feature in my remarks at every forum where peace is discussed. I quote, "Peace is not something you wish for. It is something you make, something you do, something you are, and something you give away." End of quote. While expressing my gratitude for being part of this effort to contribute to a new world order, social order, that will promote and facilitate everlasting peace, I want to commend the founding fathers of Global Peace Foundation International for their foresight, wisdom, and never-relenting hard work. I also wish to thank them for inviting me here today. I would like also to extend my profound gratitude to Dr. Mrs. Moon for appointing me as a member of the GP Women International Advisory Council and finding me worthy and capable of serving. I thank you more sincerely for this honor. Long live Global Peace International. Long live Global Peace Women. Thank you most sincerely for your attention.